Hey folks, Sardar here, and in this episode of Dev with Sardar, I'm going to introduce AssemblyScript. This is a version of Microsoft's TypeScript that compiles to WebAssembly, and it makes writing WebAssembly modules as easy as writing TypeScript itself. Now, WebAssembly, or WASM for short, is a bytecode execution format for programs. It was originally designed for programs in the browser to potentially run at high speed, and now it's being used in a much wider context in much the same way that JavaScript itself has been. Now, if you've been hesitant to do anything with WASM because it seems intimidating or because the toolchain is hard to use, AssemblyScript looks like a really good way to bridge that gap. So I'm going to show off a basic AssemblyScript project and how to work with it. Now, to set up AssemblyScript, first you're going to need a node.js installation. So create a new directory, and with node, we type npm init to get a new node project started. And then to install AssemblyScript itself, we do npm install dash dash save dev AssemblyScript. And once the install is finished up, we will have a utility, npx, that we use to create and manage the AssemblyScript part of this project. So to get AssemblyScript itself started here, we type npx as init dot, and this will create a quick demonstration project. And this includes all the scaffolding that you need to get started with AssemblyScript. There's a basic Hello World module. There's a basic test suite. There's an HTML page with the WASM module that we've created embedded in it already. So a lot of the things that we would need to create are already there for us. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch to a project I've already created to talk in more detail about these things. So by default, the main module for the AssemblyScript code in your project is going to be named index.ts. And it can be found in this directory here. And inside it, we have the functions that have been written to be used externally by non-AssemblyScript code, by the rest of our TypeScript programs, and they're decorated with the export keyword. You'll also notice that the types that we have decorated the function signatures with are more like the machine-level types that you would see in C or Rust. They're not like the number types that you would see in TypeScript, which could be ambiguous as to their bitness or their signedness. We need to have that kind of type information with AssemblyScript to get the most out of it. So that's why we have those decorations here. Now, the functions themselves don't do very much. They're just for showing off how things work. The first function adds together two 32-bit integers and returns the result. The other adds together two 32-bit floats. And these have to be separate functions with separate names. AssemblyScript does not let you perform signature overloading. We cannot have two different implementations of a single function with the same name that have different signatures. So we can't have add for int and add for float. We have to have distinct names for each one. The types that are going to be available to AssemblyScript programs are going to be a little limited compared to TypeScript. But one of the common types available is strings, and they come with a slew of methods that should also be familiar to TypeScript users. So with this function, I'm taking a string, and I'm returning a version of the same string with the exclamation points all stripped out. I should note that WebAssembly by itself cannot accept or return a complex object like a string, at least not yet. So AssemblyScript provides some shimming to do that transparently to make the process easy for us. But again, the big advantage of working with AssemblyScript is that it's just basically TypeScript plus. If you know TypeScript already, it takes very little effort to get up to speed with the types that you need to pass and the way things work. I should also point out here that where you use AssemblyScript is going to matter. Anything involving heavy computation, any heavy math, any transformations on matrices, things like that, that's the kind of thing that's best delegated into a WASM module. You don't need to make your entire program into AssemblyScript for it to be effective. You can do this. It's just that it's most often easier to write TypeScript where TypeScript will do and write WASM or write AssemblyScript for the parts of the program that need it the most. And the other thing to keep in mind is that when you make calls into the AssemblyScript part of the program, each call between JavaScript and AssemblyScript, or JavaScript and WebAssembly, rather, is going to incur some overhead. So you want to minimize the number of calls back and forth whenever possible. Now, I mentioned before how an AssemblyScript project comes with a basic test fixture set. Since we only have three very basic functions here, I've only written three tests to give you the idea of how things work. So we would run this test suite with npm test, and as you can see, everything passes. Finally, another nice piece of boilerplate that's created automatically with AssemblyScript projects is a web page with an embedded reference to the existing assembly. Now I've modified mine here to run just my string replacement routine. And in order to show this in action, I have to actually launch a little web server to load the page. We cannot run WASM on file loaded web pages. So I can use the npm package HTTP server to do that. And if we load the page in question, we get this minus all the exclamation points embedded directly into the text. And all it takes to do this is to invoke our WASM code with a simple function call, just like we would with a regular JavaScript function. So to sum up, AssemblyScript is a TypeScript variant that compiles straight to WebAssembly. The tooling should be familiar to JavaScript and TypeScript users, and the syntax too, although you will want to take some time to learn about the type system. And the best use of AssemblyScript is going to be for small units of code that perform computationally intensive work, rather than trying to port an entire program, as that might not be the most efficient use of WebAssembly's power. So this is well worth sitting down and experimenting with if you're curious about getting a leg up with WebAssembly in general. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Dev with Sardar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.